Well, that's kind of a problem.
Okay, well, now everything is on. They should hear you, me, and the game.
Okay, yeah, that's good. Can you get to a screen where there's, like, the ability to see the whole screen and not just the menu?
Yeah, sure, 1 second. Sorry.
Thank you, that's per- the FF2 title screen is perfect.
Yeah, it's just going to go up to the demo if I don't do anything. Sorry if I drop my OBS crash or anything. It has been doing that for a few times now.
Just a second again to like edit some stuff. Alright, cool. And this should put us, like, right back on schedule, almost. So, I have the timer ready, so whenever you're ready, I'm good to go.
Yeah, I'm pretty much ready. Sorry if there is going to be lack of commentary sometime. I'm just not feeling it really well right now.
Hey, that's fine. That's fine. Just enjoy the game.
Alright, so whenever, I guess. Do you have any name you want to see? Instead of. Well, I'm not going to say that on stream, but. Something really inappropriate.
Name Leon Bread, I guess.
Bread? Alright.
Because I really like Leon.
Yeah, he's the only good character in this game anyway. Alright, I'm ready now.
Alright. Count me down.
Alright, 3, 2, 1, go. Well, right now there's nothing else that is going to happen for about 15 minutes. Pretty much go through the game objectives, sword triggers and stuff. While doing the level ups, and oh yeah, the level up in this game work differently than Origins. In Origins, you have to do this attack cancel thing like 100 times to get a level up, but in this game, you don't. In fact, it doesn't even work. In this game, you have to attack a certain number of time before getting base experience. And after that, you get like 5%, I think, for every attack. So we're gonna use that to power level to level 7, barehanded and shield. So we can max out on evasion and fist damage for early. Oh, also, we're not gonna see Bread for like, I don't know, 85% of the run.
So. Yep, all according to plan.
Also, I'm gonna use something, well, not use, but you know, do something encounter manipulation. Which is not really manipulating much, except knowing where you're gonna get encounters. This helps for the final dungeon. If I ever make it there with that. I'm just going to remove everything from my characters and run to the shop real quick. I'm gonna buy shields for my two other character, so they can also level up bare-handed and shield level. Okay. I meant to actually buy two of those shields, not one. So now we're gonna try to get level 3 bandit and shield. Oh my god, Omegas. No, there's definitely no RNG. So now Maria should get a level up, and Therion is level 2, Maria is level 2. Guy has absolutely no level or no experience, which is a bad thing. Nope. Actually, everybody's gonna get experience too. So yeah, you want level 3 before going back, or you know, on the way back, to make it easier for yourself in Semitfall. So right now everybody's level 2 banded, which is the usual. Getting level 3 is just RNG because of enemy groups that you get. Sometimes you get one enemy, sometimes you get 4, sometimes 3. And you want 4 of them all the time. So to get level 3 now, I need to attack exactly 2 times to get the base experience. If I don't do that, I don't get any experience. So I'm just gonna attack 2 times with Maria, so she gets level 3. She should get level 3. Okay, there she goes. Alright, so on the way back, if I can, I'm not going to use her at all to do damage. Why use the PSP version? Because PSP is good. Probably the easiest version to do runs of this game. Oh. Okay, well this group, this enemy just doesn't matter. Doesn't give you anything. So in case my character gets too low, you can take potions in these chests to, I guess, make it safer on the way back. Yo, Whiskey. And Cabrone. LADX is in this house. Alright, so now I'm not gonna use Maria ever, and wow, this guy just ran away. This doesn't give me any experience, so it was a waste of time. As long as one of them run away, well, I mean, every time one of them run away, it just means you get no experience at all. Therion will get a level up soon. Making it level 3 is just a pain. Enemy decides to run away. Also, if you notice, the stats don't really level up the way they should. Like getting HP for... well, not doing anything. So now I'm gonna try to get Guy level 3 in the next 2 fights, if hopefully I get 2 enemies, at least 2 enemies in the next one. Ferion might die. Not really a big deal, because he's gonna get revived anyway. Alright, there we go. Everybody's level 3 now. I will be using the next character, or I guess the guest character that you can get to level up without actually getting hit. RNG. So here we get Minhu. He is going to give us the boat here. You're not really obligated to do this, but getting the Dreadnought keyword here is really, really useful. So you don't have to backtrack all the way again. No. Alright, so we're gonna put everybody in the back row here. So nobody will get attacked by direct attack or melee attack by any enemies. It's all going to get directed to get character. So in this cave, the worst encounter you could get is soldier and goblin guard. And the reason why is the worst is because most of them need the bow ability, which pretty much wrecked your entire team, like they are doing right now. Yeah, there's another group that you can actually encounter, which is the Slime group, which are pretty much immune to melee attack this early. Awesome. At least one person's gonna die here, pretty sure. Actually, I'm gonna attack 4 times. Now to get level 4, I need to attack 4 times, and Guy died. Great. At least if nobody else can die here, it would be amazing. Good, Kravone, I am not going to play Link's Awakening with like 5 months, now that you asked for it. I have to revive Guy, and I just waste time. I have to wake him up so he gets the experience, please. This is literally the worst start that I've ever had. I just cannot believe that. He's literally killing everybody with bow. Non-stop roll. Yeah, I'm playing badly right now. Very badly for the first encounter in this goddamn level. Oh man, give me some good damage roll already. Thank you. Garbage. Not getting the damage rolls that I want. So it forced me to use heal. Anyway. As long as I don't get that stupid group again. This is fine. That many enemies. No good. I'm gonna hope that these goblins run away. Had some rough start, but picked it back up. Now I have to get level 5, I need to attack 7 times in this one fight, and then 4 times in another fight. This is a pretty good encounter to get, since there's only one enemy and the guy will mostly use melee attacks, which will miss or do no damage, or close to no damage. Now we're level 5 on pretty much everything. Now we need to attack 13 times and another 5 times in a different fight. You get level 6. Let's just say that was 13. I was kind of expecting Furion to get wrecked. Wow, dude, I totally saw that coming too. Maria getting sniped right before the fight ends. So not only did she not get experience, but she's the one that needed that experience. So I just did plus two steps here, so I can get one more encounter right before the boss. So Maria can actually hit level 7 before him. Time with Maria, since she did not get any experience from the previous fight, which set me back a little bit more. Now this is one group that I do not want to do. Alright, so I did get the encounter right before the boss. Murray is not gonna get level 7, but Fira and Guy will. So it's all good. Thank you. Actually, I just realized that I am level 7, so I will leave everybody in the front row. Right now, I'm gonna have to use Parion as my main character. It's the main character that will run away from fight. Maria is only level 6. Not a big deal, but can't really do much about it. Don't want to waste more time doing the 6 hit left for her anyway. All I need now is to kill a lot of goblins. This is the moment that I want all the goblins to counter, because they drop more money than anything. If I do get the bigger drop, I get over 100 gil every time, or 200 in this case. And I needed to buy a lot of fireworks. So I just missed one of these steps, because it's easy to actually fail going directly to the objective, thanks to running at all times. Oh well. Now I'm gonna go get the pass so I can access the warship later, and just to trigger story stuff too. Thank you. I'm surprised that I'm still in the manipulation right now. Usually would have failed it way earlier than this.
Thank you.
But yeah, I just missed one time because apparently that's a thing. That will teach me to try to go fast. Yes, this is me farming, also. This is the place that I'm gonna have to start using fire domes because you cannot run from these encounters. Well, certain you cannot run from. And this one is. So, yeah. Welcome to RNG now. So, it's gonna be a lot of ambush. And plenty of fights that I'm not going to be able to run away from. It all depends on RNG. It's all that now. And I farmed 200, well, 100, I was gonna farm 190,000 skill, but I failed once, and so yeah, I'm gonna be short 10k, well, I am gonna get short 10k, but not going to be a big deal anyway. And since I failed to do the no miss grid, I think I have an eye potion that I can actually use on Jova if he doesn't die. And that's just to make sure that he stays alive until the boss at least. So the groups that you cannot run away from in this dungeon are the grenades and the ghoul, deadhead, and company group, and that's pretty much it. Getting ambushed by ghoul just hurts a lot. Alright, that was a really good ice cave. Only used two fire tomes so far. Yep, two fire tomes, so we are fine until the boss now. No encounters left. I'm gonna have to remove these guys' equipment and save, because the next boss, without Maria, is gonna be a little bit more RNG. And he missed. Nice. So we good now. Good. And I got the diamond shield. Awesome. This is a really rare drop, actually. Okay. Back. Put these guys back in the back row for the few encounters left in this cave. How do I manage it? I just don't go crazy when I get wrecked by RNG. You must not care about RNG to run this game. Yay, alright. Since there's a grenade in this group, I cannot run away. I really just only one more encounters here. Encounter? Well, one more that I have to do before the boss. So remove everything for him. So the boss is really freaking easy. Pretty much dies in one hit. Getting all the useless drop as well. Yep, fists in this game are just broken early on. The strongest attack you can use, because it doesn't matter what you have equipped except if you have a shield, I guess. So we're just gonna give him some shields so he can dodge attacks and stuff. Yes and no, because in the run, the speedrun, you just don't care about stats and other stuff like that. Because you don't need to care about it, it's really useless. The only thing you need to care about is evasion, and that's it. Nothing else. Maybe agility, but that's just a detail. A minor detail. Also, having guy in the front row with two shield gives him, well, the front row doesn't give him any evasion, but the two buckler just makes him dodge like 80% of the attacks. Melee attacks, that is. This is going to be the first shopping trip that we're going to do in this game. We're just going to buy a lot of... Well, not a lot of those, just counter status later. We're going to buy some antidotes as well. 99 Phoenix Downs. And the most powerful tome in this game. And this is why we did the money glitch, not money glitch, but the minigame manipulation, just so we could get 99. Hey, what's up, Zach? Now, this part of the game has a few more groups that you cannot run from. Every time you, let's say, enter a different area, groups that blocks you from running away also change. So if, like, the grenade in one dungeon would not let you run, it can actually let you run away in a different dungeon, because it always changes. So in this one, you cannot run from the were-rats and the adamantoids. Alright, now we're gonna take your stuff away, because you're pretty useless, and... yeah. So he's gonna be the meat shield, pretty much. He's going to, tank every hit, probably die a few times. That is kind of expected. Cannot run away from this group. I would use teleport tomes, but the shadow is immune to it. Alright, this is the part where I will need a lot of fire tome, mainly for groups like this one. But I should have enough to go through the entire ship, even if I did get undead on every single one. And before it, I do actually get undead on every single encounter. You know, I'm pretty sure this undead RNG is going to bite me in the ass at the end. I don't know why, but I have a feeling. Alright, well, I cannot run from the mine. Barrier teleport every single one of them. I still cannot believe how FF2 destroyed the entire Final Fantasy relay. It's still incredible. I am still shocked, to be honest. Still shocked of this RNG. I mean, who would not be shocked after getting wrecked by RNG for like 4 hours straight? See a war. Don't think trying to run away was a smart move. Now Gordon has to be revived. I know he loves to kill the floor, but he has better use for me. Thank you. Mary, the search. Fucking that's my only comfort that I never seen. Well, I guess luck. Oh well. Odious Kip, what are you talking about? Don't know what you're talking about. Pre-recorded gameplay. I wish. Hello? Fire? Alright, now coming up is one of the worst segments of the game. Well, not the next dungeon, but right after that is one of the worst. Because the worst enemy will start appearing. And that enemy can... If you actually encounter them, you can lose up to 5 minutes per encounter, depending on how many spawns. Or how many you actually fight. Or if you're me, you're gonna get the green version, which is gonna waste even more time. This is not good, actually. I have plus one step. okay. Now I have plus 5. Dang. I can probably save it, I hope. Somehow. now I do not understand anything. I'm supposed to be plus 5 on my stats, but it appears to be lower. Not like I'm gonna complain anyway. I honestly don't know how far I am in the manipulation. Right now it's just not clear in my head. Alright, I'm gonna start saving here because getting a yield soul encounter equals what? Well, I'm looking at the map, and apparently I'm getting encounters where I'm not supposed to get them. I'm like one step ahead. That doesn't make any sense. Absolutely make no sense. Alright, whatever. Let's try to do plus 4 and hope that I don't get any encounters anywhere. Well, that I get the encounters where I'm supposed to get them. But it's... Alright, I'm still not getting encounters where I'm supposed to get them. Although I am pushed it. So everybody's gonna get wrecked, and I'm probably be forced to reset. Yep, it does look like it. First reset. I usually don't die against this encounter, but I try to run away and that just screwed me up big time. Also, not putting him in the back row with bucklers. Also, I was actually asking for trouble. So apparently, I am plus. No, I am minus two step. Two steps ahead. Let's see if that's right. Well, I don't want to say I'm still in the manipulation somehow, but one step ahead. So yeah, that's a good thing. Very good thing. I mean, I can salvage this manipulation somehow. Or I can just stay one step ahead the whole time. You know what? I'm getting tired of the Yellow Souls. Really freaking tired. Wrong menu. I'm gonna leave this guy in the front row. And yeah, I had to reset because the Yellow Souls are just the worst. Fighting six of them will make me waste like 6 minutes. Another reason to actually save and reset after or before every encounter. Alright, let's try that again. I totally misclicked that. I did not mean to resort. You guys are actually lucky that you have hours of sleep in you. I don't sleep at all. Well, maybe a few hours every night. I'm gonna save here again because there's an encounter coming up. And I do not want to reset because Yell Souls. I'm just gonna try to avoid fighting them. One more encounter on this floor. Yell Souls. You know what? It's not even worth trying. In my opinion, it is better. In my opinion, it is better than one. I would rather play this than one. And the RNG in this game or version is fantastic. I mean, do you not see how many yellow souls I actually got? You can tell this version is awful. Hey, guess what? More of them. More of them again. If you even try to fight them, they're just gonna cast spell nonstop, and that's just not what you want. Dude, I'll take 2 ill gigas any day. Even if it takes like ages to teleport them sometime, I would rather do that than fight ill souls. Also, this one floor has a big percentage of yellow souls encounters. You don't get it all the time, but most of the time, you'll just fight them. Thank you. And I try to run away again. Encounter a kill. Oh yeah, that remind me. Happy birthday to Peter Afro, birthday boy. It's his birthday every day, so wish him a happy birthday again. And I'm probably dead because I did not survive. And now for the most RNG boss in the game. So you can kill her in one teleport book, or you could waste over 35 books. I think the most books I've used on her was something like 34 or something, and she still killed me. Thank you. I did not mean to do that. I swear. Did not mean to enter that freaking room. I'm just trying to... Okay, that's a little bit better. I am minus one now. Not bad. Minus one on manipulation. Amazing. Why PSP? Because PSP is good. Probably the easiest too. I feel like I'm repeating myself and I don't like it. Thank you. It's not as nice as the GBA one. To be honest, I would rather play this one than GBA. Any day. Talking about sleep, I really need to sleep. Can you please stop casting blades? Well, at least both of them died. There's that. Alright, another boss which can take infinite teleport whips to kill. And die in one hit. Oh my god, Green Souls. Automatic reset. Can I not get those? Oh my god, don't tell me I didn't save in the other floors. Well, that's just great. Just great. Also, what the hell am I even doing now? I'm just not paying attention to anything anymore. Probably me, it's probably the lack of sleep, probably everything. Doesn't really matter. Or it's just RNG. Well, that green soul did not waste too much time, probably like a minute and a half. Only, it's not a big deal. There's a very low chance of actually fighting them, so still surprised that I actually hit them. The more I fuck up, the less sleep I'll get, so it's a good thing, right? I think so. Peter Afro, time happy birthday. It's his birthday every day, except on September 27th. Don't listen to him, that's not his birthday. He's only saying that to get attention, so do not give it to him. that we should be dead by now. Which one is the curse? This one. Dude, the run is not really looking great. Okay, the run is looking great. I'm not looking great. It's fine. It's fine. Shit. Just to make it a bit easier on myself, I will make cottage so I can buy 2 Oli books. I don't even know why I got the fire books, but they will be useful later if I ever need them, I guess. Alright, there we go. I won't need any money for the rest of the game anymore. No more books. Better save before I get wrecked by RNG again. Alright, that reminds me, everybody now is in the front row for some reason. I did not agree to that. Mariah's curse, that is not gonna be good if I encounter those knights, because they are not gonna die in one turn. They might just cast break and screw me over again, like always. Alright, now this is where I'm gonna start saving on every floor. There is a big chance of fighting yellow souls in this dungeon. Or, you know, any kind of soul, really. So we're just gonna play it safe a little bit. Emulator, what is that? Yeah, this is actual console. I don't do emulator stuff. Not for PSP, at least. This is a Ed video cable. It might look like a little bit like emulator. So, I don't know. But yeah, I can assure you this is not emulator. This is actual console. Okay, maybe I do emulator for certain games because I don't actually own them, but hey. Console LEDX? Ah, dude, you're killing me. Okay, let me see. I'll do console LEDX in 2 weeks. How about that? 2 weeks. Okay, no, 2 weeks and a half. Exactly. 2 weeks and a half, and I'll do LEDX on console. And, just keep an eye out for BlizzCon, because that's probably where I'll be. Oh my god, did I really try to run away from that? Please don't break. Please don't break. Okay. I already did console LEDX last year. Where the hell were you, Muffin? Where the hell were you? You were nowhere. That's right. Yeah, just kind of 2 weeks or something? I don't know. 2 weeks and a half to be exact. And I'll be, I don't know, playing some random games. Hey. I actually did open a menu again. Yeah, that was a year ago, but I still play it on console. So. Sometimes here, that's pretty accurate actually. I'm playing right, cannot run from that. Keep an eye out for the shit block. You will not regret that. Not regret watching that, actually. A lot of shit game coming this year. I wonder if Shaq is still playing.